Hello friends, I am Dr. S.K. Mittal. In this lecture, I will explain the application of Laplace transform in the network analysis. For this, I have considered a circuit. In this circuit, the question is, find out the Laplace transform equivalent of the network shown. The switch is closed at t is equal to 0. Determine the resulting current IT. In this question, there are two questions are there. First is the Laplace transform of equivalent circuit, which is shown in this figure, and second is the resulting current IT. The first of all, we will try to obtain the Laplace transform equivalent of the network shown. In such type of circuits, first of all, a stepwise calculation is done, and in first step, what we must do in all the questions, the first step is to calculate the initial condition. To calculate the initial condition, what we must do? We must observe the circuit and we must count the energy storing elements. In this circuit, only this inductor is the energy storing element. We know that inductor and capacitor are energy storing elements. Therefore, initial condition of energy storing elements are calculated. Since this circuit is consisting of only this inductance of 0.01 henry, therefore initial condition of this inductor is calculated. Now, to calculate the initial condition of this inductor, we see the circuit. Circuit says that switch is closed at t is equal to 0. Therefore, switch is closed at t is equal to 0. According to circuit, switch is closed at t is equal to 0. To calculate the initial condition, we must see that what is the condition of switch before t is equal to 0. Before t is equal to 0, or it is also represented by t is equal to 0 minus. Since switch is closed at t is equal to 0, therefore before t is equal to 0, or t is equal to 0 minus, what is the condition of circuit? We observe that the switch will be certainly open. And if switch is certainly open before t is equal to 0, or at t is equal to 0 minus, what will be the circuit? This is the voltage applied. Its value is given. Switch is opened at t is equal to 0 minus. This is the resistance of R is equal to 5 ohm, and this is the inductance of 0.01 henry. And now Since the circuit current is represented by IT, and in this circuit we are considering the current at t is equal to 0 minus, therefore this current I will represent by I0 minus. It must be noted that if inductor is in the circuit, then its initial condition is always calculated in terms of current, and if capacitor is there, then initial condition is calculated in terms of voltage. Since it is this circuit is consisting only inductor, therefore I am going to calculate the initial condition in terms of current. See, this is the voltage source and this is the inductor. Since at t is equal to 0 minus, the switch is open. The switch is open. Therefore, according to observation, we can say that since source is not connected to inductor, then current I0 minus will be equal to 0. Therefore, initial current of this inductor is 0, means we have calculated the initial condition. So this is the initial condition. It is the first step. I0 minus is equal to 0. If we want to calculate the current at t is equal to 0 plus, then I0 plus will also be equal to 0. It is also the initial condition. Why I0 plus is equal to 0? Because in the inductor, current cannot be changed simultaneously in very short duration. Therefore, we know that I0 minus is equal to I0 plus. In some questions, I0 plus is also also to be calculated. Therefore, I am considering I0 plus also here. Then it is also equal to 0, because the current change from t is equal to 0 minus to t is equal to 0 plus is not possible, because it is a very short duration, and therefore this condition is obtained. So we have calculated the initial condition in this system. After calculating the initial condition, we draw the in second step, we draw the time domain circuit at t greater than 0. Now, what will be the circuit for t greater than 0? The question says that at t is equal to 0, the switch is closed. Therefore, certainly at t greater than 0, switch will be closed. And therefore, this is the voltage source Vt. Its value is 100 sine 500 t. Now at t greater than 0, I have said that switch will be closed, and this is the inductor, resistance R is equal to 5 ohm, and inductor of 0.01 Henry, and the current is IT. So this is the time domain circuit at t greater than 0. From this circuit, in next step, we obtain the Laplace equivalent circuit which is asked in the question. Laplace transform circuit. Now, if any time domain circuit is given and if it is to be converted into Laplace transform equivalent, then first of all, it must be decided that we are going to solve the question by mesh analysis or nodal analysis. Now see, the current represented here is a mesh current. Therefore, we will use the mesh analysis method. Because why it is necessary to decide the method by which current will be calculated? Because there are separate Laplace transform equivalent of inductor and capacitor in case of mesh analysis and nodal analysis. Therefore, since it is the mesh current, therefore certainly we will use the mesh analysis. Now, after deciding the method, we will change the time domain circuit into Laplace transform. Now, see, this inductance will be changed. Resistance is unchanged because it is not frequency dependent component. If now I am going to draw the Laplace equivalent of inductor in case of KVL method or mesh analysis. See, if L Henry inductor is given, then its Laplace transform equivalent will be L into S. It will be in ohm because mesh analysis and KVL analysis, we generally apply the KVL method where the values are in ohms. Therefore, L Henry inductor is converted into ohm. And in series with this, there is a voltage source having polarity like this, which I have explained in previous lectures. So this is the L Henry inductor equivalent in Laplace transform. Now, by knowing this, I am going to convert this time domain circuit into Laplace transform. So first of all, there is the voltage source Vt. Now Vt value is 100 sine 500 t. We know that the Laplace transform of sine omega t is omega divided by s square plus omega square. Therefore, the value of Vt the value of Vt in transform, Laplace transform, will be Vs. And therefore, in place of Vt in Laplace transform, we will say Vs. And the value of 100 sine 500t according to this expression will be 100 multiplied by Vt is equal to 100 sine 500t. Means here omega is 500. Therefore, its Laplace transform means Vt Laplace transform will be 100 multiplied by omega, omega means 500 divided by s square plus omega square, s square plus omega square means 500 square. So this is the value. Switch is will be closed. Resistance is there. R is equal to 5 ohm. In Laplace transform and time domain, resistance is unchanged. Now there is inductance of 0.01 Henry. So according to this method, the L Henry inductor is the combination of LS and this voltage source. So now I will represent LS, where L is equal to 0.01S and it will be in ohm. This is the voltage source. Its value is L into I0 minus, means 0.10 value of L multiplied by initial condition I0 minus. I have already calculated in step 1 and it is 0. Therefore, it is equal to 0. So, this is the Laplace equivalent Laplace transform equivalent of inductor in KVL. Now, the current IT is there. Current IT will be converted, since VT is converted into VS, means FT is converted into FS. Similarly, IT will be converted into IS. Therefore, it is the first question answer we have obtained. It is the Laplace transform equivalent of the circuit. Now, first answer I have given. Now, we will go to go for the calculation of IS. So, now, to calculate the IS, we will simplify the circuit. The value of VS is the 100 multiplied by 500, means it will be 5 into 10 to the power 4 divided by S square plus 500 square, and it is the voltage source, it will be in volts. Now, there is a resistance R is equal to 5 ohm, and see, the value of this voltage source is 0 volt, and 0 volt means short circuit. Therefore, in place of this, we will make short circuit. In this way, circuit is simplified and this will be IS. Now, this is a single mesh. For this single mesh, we will apply the mesh analysis method, which I have already described. Since it is a single mesh, then first I will write IS multiplied by, on this periphery, on the periphery of this mesh, there are two ohmic values, 5 ohm plus 0.01S. There is no other mesh, it is equal to 0. In the direction of IS, the source is going from negative to positive, means it is a case of voltage rise, and therefore it will be 5 into 10 to the power 4 divided by S square plus 500 square. So this is the mesh analysis equation. Now, the value of IS is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 4 divided by 0.01S plus 5. This term is divided into, it will be written into denominator. Now this is the value of IS. Now to calculate the value of IT, inverse Laplace transform is required. And for inverse Laplace transform, the IS must be in standard form. Therefore, to change the value of IS into standard form, IS is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 4 divided by, say, this is 0.01s plus 5. Generally, the standard form is 1 upon s plus a. It has inverse Laplace transform e to the power minus at. So, therefore, the terms must be like this. So, therefore, we must keep common the value 0.01. Therefore, is taken common, s plus 5 divided by 0.01, s square plus 500 square, and if I consider this, then it will be 5 into 10 to the power 6 divided by s plus 500 s square plus 500 square. This is the value, final value of s. Now see, this value is first order, it is the second order. Now how we will change? It is the first order, like 1 upon s plus a. Therefore I will write a divided by s plus 500 plus, it is the second order, and for second order, according to mathematics, partial fraction expansion, it will be bs plus s square plus 500. Now a, b, c are the residues, and these residues we can calculate by equating the terms. Therefore, it will be a s square plus 500 square plus b s plus c s plus 500 divided by s plus 500 s square plus 500 square. Now, the value of IS is represented by this equation, and now we have to calculate the residues a b and c. Now to calculate the value of a, b, c, here I will write the value of equation d, which is the value of is. Now see, this denominator is same, therefore I will equate the numerator. So now, if I am equating the numerator, a s square plus 500 square plus b s plus c s plus 500 is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 6. Now, if I multiply, and then it will be 500 square into a plus bs square plus 500s into b plus c into s plus 500c is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 6. Now, if I collect the s square term and s term, then this equation will be, if I collect s square term, s term and constant term, then the equation will be a plus b s square plus s 500b plus c plus 500 square a plus 500c is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 6. Since at the right hand side there is no s term and therefore there is no s square term, therefore by comparison with the right hand side I can say that a plus b is equal to 0, because there is no s square term at right hand side, there is no s term, s to the power 1 term at the right hand side, therefore 500b plus c is equal to 0. And now this is the constant term, 500 square a plus 500c is equal to constant term 5 equal to. If I solve these three equations, the value of a is equal to 10, value of b is equal to minus 10, and value of c is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 3. I have made the three equations. It is a simple equation. You can solve, and after solving, I have got this value. If I have obtained this value, now I will put the value of ABC in equation D. Then IS is equal to, the value of A is 10 divided by S plus 500 plus B means minus 10 into S, BS plus C, and C is 5 into 10 power 3 divided by S square plus 500 square. I have put all these ABC values into equation D. See this equation D, which I have represented here. Now, to obtain the inverse Laplace transform, it is required to represent this standard form 10 1 upon S plus 500, and if I separate this minus 10 S divided by S square plus 500 square plus 5 into 10 to the power 3 divided by S square plus 500 square. Now see how many standard forms I have got here. It is similar to 1 upon S plus A. This term is similar to S upon S square plus omega square. Now this is similar to, there is no S term in the numerator, therefore it will be omega divided by S square plus omega square. If this term is 1 upon S plus A, its inverse Laplace transform is e to the power minus a t. S divided by s plus s square cos omega t and omega upon s square plus omega square, it is having inverse Laplace transform of sin omega t. Now, this equation n, which represents the value of is, has three standard form. Therefore, if I take inverse Laplace transform, then the value of it, the value of it is the inverse Laplace transform of is. Now see, the value of is 10 divided by, it is similar to this first standard form, then it will be 10. The value of a is 500, so e to the power minus 500 t. The second term, minus 10 multiplied by s divided by s square plus 500 square, where omega is 500, therefore it will be cos 500 t. Now the third term, here omega is 500, omega square is 500 square, therefore omega is 500, therefore I can write 5 into 10 to the power 3 divided by s square plus omega square, 500 square is equal to 10 multiplied by 500 divided by s square plus 500 square. Now omega is 500, therefore I can take 10 sine 500 t. So this is the value of it using Laplace transform. Thank you.